If you're a registered installer or electrician and like to see some videos on how you can improve your skills and talents, then we've made some terrific videos on this channel. So please subscribe, and any hints or tips or comments, please put them in the comments below. I'll be happy to respond and help you out. If you have a central heating system and you'd like to know where to find an installer or engineer that you can trust, then I've made some special videos for you in hints and tips, controls, etc., to make your heating system much, much better. And this is what we do on the channel. So if you do have any comments, please put them down in the comment below and subscribe to our channel. Thank you very much and take care. To find out if there are any faults in the system, as we walk into the house and we just want to put the boiler through its paces, we test the central heating side, because it's very easy to press buttons rather than the hot water. So whatever the fault, always test the heating first. A good idea in the summer is to switch the heating on for 2 or 3 or 4 minutes just to make sure everything works, because quite often these seize up throughout the summer. Come autumn time, they won't work, and we get a call out saying, I've got hot water but no central heating. So this is the way we always test the whole system. First of all, we need to power it up, and we look at the programmer. So there we've got two lights on, so we need to just turn the hot water to off and the heating to constant. Okay, it must be constant, no other setting is acceptable. So now what we're going to do is turn the room thermostat up to the highest position possible. And we'll find that this motorized valve will start moving away, as you can see here. So I'm just touching it, and the boiler and the pump has kicked in. So far so good, this is fully opened. Now, when we turn the room thermostat off, the boiler goes out, but the valve remains fully open, and this is quite often not happening, and the installer thinks there's something wrong, which there is. Obviously it shouldn't close from autumn to spring. It stays open in mid position or fully open. So now it stops the motor burning out. We turn the room thermostat up, and within 5 seconds the boiler should refire, and that passes. But what we do again now is to turn the heating control to off, and the boiler and the pump has gone off. But if you look, the valve is still open. When we select hot water constant and we turn the thermostat, instantly we get hot water, but the valve will now close. And it'll stay closed throughout the summer up until the autumn. And that's the problem. It may and often will seize up. So the way we test it is that we simply turn this off and the valve is closed. Turn it on, and for the second time, we turn the programmer to off. So that is now fully tested and working. And as I said earlier, do this sequence every single time that you enter a house or you do some repairs. Just double check. Somebody needs to switch it on and off. What we've also got here is a resistor, and it's called the snubber. This Honeywell Y Plan has a weak spot that if there's any electricity on the neutrals, the boiler could fire up with as little as 20 volts AC. And of course, that's unnerving. You can get that resistor from any electronic company that sells components. You should seek advice for that, because we're in the electronics world. So I hope you've found this useful, and you stick to this system that Honeywell has told us to follow, how to test a Y plan.